Well, hello, dear viewers, and welcome to the beautiful streets of Singapore. First thing that I have to say is what is going on with the timing. Why is race clutch 2 to 3 times quicker? And then I'm still in P2 despite being 2.5 tenths off P1. When did McGogi become so quick? Is that a car on a lap? No. Maybe that one is? Yeah. Hi Alex, my commiserations again. Well, you did. But still, in my mind, that means that he will absolutely die in the race. But if race clutch have done very good homework, then maybe he's 2 tenths quicker in the race as well. Very tough luck for Jake. I hope he recovers quick. That first gear is gonna kill me. Why am I downshifting? Such a nice track anyway. I really enjoy every time we came here. Well, I guess time for one more flyer. Hi, Irun, thank you. Yeah, I don't know, like, looking at this leaderboard or current standings, I am quite confused.
This is a whisper test. Can everybody hear me? This is a whisper test.
We can hear.
Alright, then welcome everyone to the fourth round for today. Fourth round of the season. There are no
Victor,
special,
I don't remember, to be honest,
exceptions for this track.
Did I do that?
The only important thing is I would like to emphasize is that because the walls are very near to the track and there are narrow parts, please be very careful in the first opening laps when the field is still bunched together so we don't get any pile-ups or stuff like this. And also leave each other room, don't push other drivers into the wall, just be respectful on track, and yeah, I wish you good luck and fun. If you have any questions, feel free to ask.
Thank you, Thomas. Others, it's Amici.
I'm sorry.
Where is the home? It was quite funny.
It was not. But I can imagine. Ah.
What are those gaps?
I don't know. I actually felt fast once, and if I don't do a 0.7, I'm gonna start outside the top 10 again.
Yeah, Alex, I think the Rimmer Road is very, very good, very quick.
Although, like, I can do 0.7. Really.
Yeah, I think Rimmer Road is quicker.
Yeah, it is. It is much quicker.
Wanted to downshift but missed the pedal. Embarrassing. Lost half a tenth in last corner. What did I do wrong? Wait, I always forget which button is. Aha, this is the one. This is one to go back. Point 214, and I could do 0.376. Well, again, very surprising to see myself well about the first apex. I have no clue what to do there. Every line seems to work or not work depending on the lap. Full scent indeed. I'm just not sure about that long anti-cut on the right. I think I saw people using that in pro. I never tried.
Best of luck.
Best of luck to you as well.
Enjoy the artificial front wings everywhere.
Oh yeah, forgot about that. Yeah, I will not touch that anti-cut, but I think I saw, like, I think pro server was lagging a lot, so it was quite confusing to see what lines the different cars are taking. So I got the idea that maybe some are using the anti-cut, but probably not. Thank you, M19. Well, I mean, add another zero to the price pool and ball will be 29. Not just ball, but like top 5 or top 10 even. Yeah, Alex was, yeah, not too stable connection-wise. Yeah, one issue with this track is that I don't even have time to grab my drink and drink it, let alone being up to date with the chat, so sorry if I miss some messages. Either way, let's make another 0.5 at least. Not best. Oof. Yeah. I don't know what line to take before the bridge. I keep braking later and later for that old Singapore sling, and the car is still making the corner. But at some point, it will not make the corner. I think I lost 3/10 in this upcoming corner. I just braked too early. Like, I braked where I thought it would be fine, but the car just stopped so fast. And then I had some snaps in the exits. Their time to gain. Who got P2? Janos. Nietzsche in P5 for now. But oh well, people will improve. Why is this thing not splitting? Like, the HUD just keeps resetting. I hate to see that line with car positions in quali when it's private quali. But I need to see the delta and the time. Sometimes it splits, sometimes it does not. Great question, Victor. Well, let's try to close the gap, at least on my side. Nein. Ay, ay, ay. Four still. Alright. Who got me? Bok and Janusz. And point two again from Oven. Yeah, I decided not to abort any lap. But at least I know that I have easy tents. I think the lap was really, really good, except that one corner, which is normally understeer for me, but I think I just went slightly too wide and missed the real road. Ay ay ay, it would be so good. Here I brake too early again, somehow, hit the apex curb. Gaps behind are interesting. Quite some gap and then just no gap at all. Sergio. Wait, Sergio won pro, right? In the end. Driving too slow. I need to again get a move on and I need to hide this stupid HUD. Let's go! Yes! Yes! Oof! Oh, I thought I lost it! What did I do wrong? I exited some corner and thought it was all gone. Yeah, Owen, I don't know, I just hope that he did full quali prep and will absolutely die in the race, but I'm so happy to be P2 somehow, I don't know.
Legend.
I'm shaking.
Same.
Oh, P5, Michi.
It's PB.
Wow. Okay.
Radio check.
Yeah.
Copy. Can we have strat talk really quick?
I don't honestly know what to do in OBS.
Yeah, okay. I think I'm gonna copy the majority of, you know, from when.
Yeah, okay.
So, yeah.
Yeah, I think same here. I will copy.
Yeah. Just need to fiddle my brain with that now. Okay, I'll keep you posted on what I see then.
Mm-hmm.
Man, it feels so good to be in the top 10 quali for once.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, same for P2, a victory, mm-hmm. Kind of. Let's consider Magogi to be Verstappen, and then we are racing for kind of Formula 1.5.
I guess we see Magogi on the full stop.
Yeah. Like, why am I going slow on the push? It's not quality. Exactly, Alex. That's the plan. Oh, where's the brakes? Just made it.
We are allowed to cross the line on the inside, right?
I think the actual line is only the one that separates track from anything that's not track on the pit entry.
Pit exit is such a challenge.
Yep. Neutral out clutch. Sounds like a way to stall the car. Time to return to pits and check the pit stop space or placement, I guess not. Except the broadcast is late. Ah, yeah, auto clutch on. Well, let's see what I will do. Auto clutch on is safe, but auto clutch off is fun. Casual. Is Owen still in hearts? He is. Is he bluffing? Am I bluffing? that would be a speeding in the pits, I think. Well, Alex, I stole the 200 kph on my practice formation laps. Somehow. True story. Not sure what kind of bugs there are, but yeah. Yep. Imola, oh no, I don't like Imola. Which is, I guess, good for me, because every time I say I don't like a track, this year I win. Well, if we can make a statistics out of one race. Ah, there we go, the Italians. Hard, soft, hard, 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 hard. I don't know. Am I gonna blow the strat again?
Just to confirm, you're not on... not on hard, right?
Yeah, currently I'm not on hard. What's the problem, Alex? Softs are good. I keep being confused by these red rings on the rims on some cars. Yeah, Alex, I hope mine will last longer. What did you say about second stint? Maybe soft, maybe hard, maybe medium. Okay, let's see. Engine is still alive. Good to hear.
Not sure if my app is wrong, but it shows Prajok and McGoy and Hearts.
Yeah, McGoy is on Hearts.
I have Williams in medium, Kranqvist Hearts, Janko Lila medium, Siebel medium, Jordan soft. It's a top 10.
Alex on medium?
Yeah, I think it hasn't updated yet.
Okay.
I'm not sure.
Alright, well, let's...
Best of luck.
Yeah, same to you. Let's see where we end up.
Yep.
Well, it could be McGoji, McGauji.
I think Yannick Bock stalled. Someone stalled. Not sure.
Well, let's see, I mean, engines should restart.
Ah, yeah, yeah.
Most likely.
Yeah, restarted.
P1. Auto clutch back on.
Big crash on the hairpin, there's a roadblock.
That opens up the three stopper, I think. Both Ferraris. Oh, poor guys. And poor Peter. It has to be Alex, if anybody else. Such an unlucky guy. Implications for the strategy. What to do here? Yes, it was a dive bomb back here. And it was a way too late dive bomb, probably. follow my bogey behind pushing big snap.
On the medium is catching us with over a second a lap. He's running in P6 after the pile up.
Yeah, I will become faster and faster eventually.
Yeah, don't worry, it's fine. Underneath is the next in P7.
Well, I mean, it's Singapore, and strategies in Singapore are interesting, so... You cannot ever know what's the tire performance and what's the driver performance, or like current strategy. Nice penalty for the Valeriano. What a meaningful message. We've won here.
chamber now in DRS. Underneath 4.4. Lila bonked the heart heavily on the exit penultimate turn.
You cooked it too much. Dropped to 37, that's too slow.
Gorilla box.
He's on a free spot, I think. mine will catch us or like overtake us. Somebody boxed from hard.
Hard runners in. Gap between us is less than 3 seconds. You're gonna do the call. I adjust.
I do another one.
Oh, he fell behind Bianco Liva. Do we consider the gap enough? 3.3.
No idea, maybe we lose a little bit.
Just try to stay out, stretch it then.
What's that? Some weird stuff. Overcut. Janik Gottes. He's in the soft stint now. Yeah, cannot cover them all. Is Magogi on soft?
Wait. Negative hard, spock on soft though.
Okay.
Nearly out of bed, but I can't keep up.
This Manu is having damage.
He does. But he's still fast. Before he cuts final turn curb and the car does nothing.
Haikas, actually, I don't know if I really use those blinking lights, but maybe more for practice. It's not slow. I wonder what his plan is on the soft.
Lila 1.1. Lila on hard, by the way.
Going for a free stopper.
Yeah, double stop.
Drink and push to pass at the same time. Must find a different solution. das hier rum, let's see. I really wonder if he's on a 2 and if he's on a 3 stopper. I don't think anybody did 19 on soft. I think I was the only one on soft in the start. Walk was some parts, no? to downshift to first. I have a bit of under still. I saw some yellow flashing, but I guess it was on the other side of the track, because that is like a junction. So when are they boxing? Must be soon. In 4 laps it's gonna be 23 to the end. Theory Anik is stretching the softs and then just taking a long hard stint to the end. But he had such an immense space on the soft. your box now?
You can.
I can make it a lot longer, so your box. I don't know what to do with tires, it's marginal between the compounds. Бог вот Януш.
Can you draft me a bit?
Yeah, I guess we are in similar situation regarding battery.
Yeah.
But I need to push to get Бог. The book is on mediums, we are on parts, right?
True. Yeah, I try to stay with you as long as possible, maybe I drop off later. Krashuk should pit lap 45.
Well, Owen will stop for softs and then be very fast. completely taken aback by the pace of Bokensoft and the soft's longevity. Incredible.
Goi had crazy pace though.
Yeah. But we got the family, the RS.
Yes. I know. Using the tire.
Scared by that gap.
I
approaches to the salt. Push, 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 like no tomorrow.
Just one lap longer, I wished. Is alive.
If you cannot stay with me, maybe then you have Bengolila's DRS, but he has yours.
Bengolila boxes again, I guess.
I don't think so.
Thank you.
We will see, he will have to overtake four cars. Sleep angle lights, yes. So all we would have 30 minutes left. It's 10 seconds to gain.
Get to me is 6 seconds of goy.
Some mediums. Interesting. 13 should be soft today. I don't know what they are doing with their tires. Owen has to make the move on this straight now. Let's see.
No chance, mate. Boy exits on the back straight with a 10th.
Good. Counting, again, 8 tenths. He's gonna need more than 8 tenths this lap. From 6.1 to 4.8, 4.7. See how this pans out. I don't know if I can pass Bock. Need his mediums to completely give up. 4.7 to 3. Okay, rip. Yannick, wait for me. Dear Carlos. No, Yannick, he did not do the job. I had more battery I would defend, but I don't. Also, I hoped Owen would get Yannick because Yannick is leading the championship. I don't think he can take Bock, although Yannick's mediums will not be good. The French strategy. Not sure if it was the strategy or the actual raw pace, because when you have three tanks over everybody in quali, it usually means something. Bock has full battery, I think. Owen has maybe 15%. So I would be extremely surprised if there is a move. Should have left him earlier, but I had the feeling that I could defend. But yeah, the tires are not great. Although he has DRS now. Too far. only have 300 hearts right now. Way too far. Hindsight, nice try to go to hard instead of medium was good. I think I could have attacked Yannick in the last lap. But 3-stopper to make it work, like everybody else on a 3-stopper is behind Michi. Like nobody could make it work except Owen.
So lucky.
Yeah, that pace was insane. So I guess whatever he would do, he would be pretty fast.
Yeah.
But also, like after that carnage in lap 1, there was so much free space behind. The 3-stopper was instantly more viable, but I was just not ready to take it.
No, the, from the position where we were, the 2-stop was the safe strat. So fucking done though.
Victor, I know the battery because...
That P4 like, feels crazy.
It's logical
good.
from what
considering everything.
Track. No, for sure, Michi, for sure. And I think we scored most points, right?
Petta in 10th, so yeah, I think.
It's a pretty lenient drop in points, I think like 35, 30, 28, or something like that.
Yeah. Goes down like 5, 4, 3, 2, and then a couple of 2s and then 1s.
Although that means that Peter did not lose too much to you, although we still should be fast. Why is Kostas riding with me? Driver swap?
I don't know exactly.
I need it.
I think Peter had low time to prepare.
Yeah, for sure. Yannick was super lucky or super clever to make it out ahead of Rakshok, and then that gap to him. Yeah, I could never recover it.
Was he ahead? I can't remember.
Yeah, Rakshok was in the middle, and then I got stuck behind Rakshok a bit, so the gap was too much. Like, I could get it back, but then the tires were gone.
I wonder if you could have hold of Megori if you were in DRS.
I would, for sure, but. Yeah, there was no science brain going on there because it was not needed as he, like Yannick won anyway without giving me DRS, so.
Yeah.
I was just too slow but just too fast to keep P2. Well, on to Silverstone. What did Race Clutch do to this car? Like, first sector was kind of balanced, in second sector it always gained a little bit, but third sector they gained like, well, 2.5 tenths or so, I don't know, 3 tenths. They were taking that curb, like, I think here, Magogi always gained.
Anyway, good job still, P3.
Yeah, thank you, and same for you.
Thank you.
Like, Magogi was taking this curve here like this, I think. So, I don't know. I never tried, I cannot see it working. So, who is pinging me? Time for... interview. Did I do a mistake? First to start on soft instead of medium, and then I think. I think here. Yeah. Come on. What am I doing? Time to find the driver's excuse. That's the gap or lack of focus that happens because I'm trying to make the stream to work. Still worth it though. It was.
Man, I nearly died. Lap 1. Granqvist outbroke into P6 and P5, and P6 got pushed into my rear.
Yeah, I need to check the replays. I think I will close the stream after the interviews.
Yeah. Poor Alex, he got simply killed.
Again, yeah.
Yeah.
It was Krankist. Jan. Why? And then I was driving so slow that Manuel caught up with me despite this.
Moved. Thanks very much, Ian McGorgie, their second place here today. Just ahead of Jurne Simicic, who also joins us now. Welcome in, Jurne. Third place for you today as well. A very interesting race to watch in terms of figuring out what was going on with the strategy and who was actually going to win in the end. How confident were you as you came out the pit lane for the final time that you were going to be the race winner today? What were you hoping for once you had made your final stop?
I was knowing that there is maybe 10% chance I can strike Yannick in the last lap if his mediums die. But I knew that it was all over. I don't know. I would need to reevaluate the strategy. I think the strategy was good. Like, I did what I thought would work the best. It actually worked quite well. Apart from forgetting to cover from Yannick's overcut. But I didn't really not have battery remaining to do that. So great job by him to spot that after first stop to keep pushing on in the first stint in the last lap. But yeah, I don't know, Owen was just so quick also.
Yeah, it was a very impressive drive from all three of you, to be honest, in terms of speed as well. What about the overtake from Owen on yourself? He said that he thought you maybe had a bit of a mistake preceding that. Was that the case, or was it a good overtake around the outside?
Like in the corner before, I went to like a coffee shop on the right side of the track. Like, I don't know, the apex just was 1 kilometer away. I don't know what happened. Well, my mistake, and I still should have dumped the remainder of the battery that I had. But then I thought, oh well, maybe around the outside it's not possible, but he made it. And then as we were side by side, I just knew that there is no way I can survive or like keep the position. So I just thought, well, let him go so he catches Yannick and maybe something happens for P1. But it was all a little bit too late because, well, he needed one more lap to get Yannick, so not ideal.
Yeah, exactly. Well, it's a second podium in a row for yourself, so congratulations on that, and thanks very much for coming to chat to us as well.
Thank you, it was a nice race, enjoyable.
It certainly was. Jurne Simicic, it's their third place in tonight's Singapore Grand Prix. And that will just about do it for us here tonight, Cam. 62 laps, but Ian McGorgie, you will have been wishing that it was an extra one again from the added sound.
All right. Well, not a win, but it was a good race. So I guess I will watch the replays a bit later. I mean, there is nothing to see apart from this crash and then everybody behind getting collected. It's a podium. I hope you guys enjoyed the stream. I was a bit slow. I was trying to do the zero wheel spin tactics. It was the fastest in my calculation. But when you have 3-tenth gap like McGorgie had, Like 3 tenths per 62 laps is what, 20 seconds? Then you can do whatever. Like it was just insane what they did with the setup. So if poor Jake had a healthy shoulder, that would be probably easy win for him. Or P1, P2. I don't know. We'll get them back at Silverstone. Until then, thank you again. Have a nice rest of the evening. See you. Bye-bye.